My name's Martin Potter. I'm a senior lecturer in the School of Communication and Creative Arts at Deakin University. And I'm also an investigator at the ARC Centre of Excellence for Australian Biodiversity and Heritage. We're in Deakin's Motion Lab and we do a whole range of immersive visualisation in this space. The project that I'm working on at the moment is called The Earth Above. It's a deep time view of Australia's epic history. What it is a planetarium feature show. So it's going to run about 25 to 30 minutes and it's going to provide audiences with an opportunity to travel back through time, sink down through the earth, to be able to kind of unpack the delicate traces of emerging archaeological discoveries that are being made and how they're being entangled with Indigenous knowledge systems. We're building a range of different virtual landscapes in Unreal Engine, and the idea is that we're trying to take people back through time into these virtual landscapes, really accurately rebuild what was there 140,000 years ago or 30,000 years ago.
I'm Scott Jackson, I'm the lead animator on the Earth Above project. So basically we're just showing how our development process with the planetarium is sort of seamless, and we can jump in VR to see a makeshift planetarium dome. Rather than having to go to an actual dome and book it out for an entire day, we can just do it virtually. At the moment I'm working on Clog's Cave, which tells a story of a Mulla Mulla, which is a medicine man. What happened in that cave, what experiences were had there. It's all backed by sort of the research that the archaeologists are doing.
We've pulled together a fantastic team. We've got some great animators doing incredible work, really, really detailed kind of, you know, virtual world building. I think most important for this particular project though, the researchers and the traditional owners who we collaborate with, the ARC Centre of Excellence is like a mesh network where you bring in all of these different researchers from lots of different institutions. It's amazing to have that kind of opportunity to collaborate with people across many different discipline areas and across the whole country, and often internationally as well. The archaeologists have been able to really, really flesh out and detail some exciting discoveries that have been happening across the country, and it's their research and that work and often their relationships with the traditional owners that has been really fundamental in like allowing this project to come to fruition.
With conventional filmmaking, the tricks of that cinematography kind of get thrown out the window a little bit when you're working with a planetarium and dome. Dealing with a 180 degree field of view, you don't really know where the viewer is going to look at a certain time. What you really want the audience looking at should be framed sort of at the bottom towards the center, despite having all this real estate that you could go nuts with. We've been experimenting with a chair that we can sort of tilt at any angle. One of the things about these planetarium domes is they all sort of differ slightly, and we're not trying to design it just for one. So we want to try and find the middle ground that gives the best experience.
It's so important to be able to actually come into a dome and see it playing back, actually being in the physical space and not just in the VR space. Yeah, it's super important, totally transforms the way that we see what we've done. It's been great to be able to have the Motion Lab as like a place where everybody can come to, and we can actually have a context to make this type of stuff. Without having the lab as like a research centre, it would be very, very hard to get large scale projects like this up. So having that kind of node of the lab is really, really important. The lab is a collaborative centre, and that's really the benefit that we feel.